Hey guys, with the release of LaunchBox 13.22, I wanted to talk about one of the new features that came with it called Game Progress Tracking. You can finally track each and every one of your games, no more forgetting what you're playing, what you dropped, all the games that you've beat. It's more than just a completing a game checkbox. It's a full-on tracking system built right into LaunchBox and Big Box, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through all the cool stuff that you can do with it. So let's start with the simple stuff. Every game now has a new progress field in the game edit window. You'll see something like this: not started, want to play. This represents a category and a value, which is separated by this slash. The first part tells you the general state of the game, while the second part kind of gets more specific. If you wanted to change this manually, simply click this drop down and choose something else. Maybe I want to play this game, so I'm going to choose not played, want to play. Done. For people that want to super customize this, you absolutely can. You want a category called backlog and maybe a value called why do I own this? Go crazy. You'll also notice a little icon here. It's a shortcut to the Game Progress Organization options page. Here's where you can create and rearrange categories and values kind of however you like. So let's say I wanted, for example, this paused value to be in front of the progress value. That's it. Now, this new order is going to show up everywhere inside of LaunchBox and Big Box. Now, sometimes you might need to just quickly adjust the game's progress value. All you have to do in the default theme is click this progress button right here, and it's going to bring up all the values that you have. You can see that the paused value is showing in front of the in progress value, which is what we just changed. Now, Banjo-Kazooie here, I played this a ton when I was a kid, so you better believe I'm going to mark that as done mastered. You can see here, it instantly updates. Now, maybe you just need to change a whole bunch at once. You can always just shift-click arrange, or you can hold control and you can kind of click ones off and on. I can open the bulk edit wizard. Go down to the progress field, and you know, as bad as they are, maybe someday I'll want to play them. So I'll mark them as want to play. Done. Now, let's say you want to quickly see which games you've beaten or which ones you're currently working on. That's where the filter tools come in. The first one is the on-the-fly filter, which is found right here. You can click it. There's now a new progress section that's going to show you all the relevant values and categories right here. All you have to do is choose a category or choose one of the values. Here I'm going to choose done, and hey, look, I beat Mega Man 2. That was an amazing game. Anyway, the second way is by using this filter drop-down menu. You can go to progress. It's going to show you all of your categories and values here in the order that you set, and you can go through them and select either a category or just specifically a value, and it's going to show you all the games that have the value that is tagged. You can see here I've got 168 games that are in progress and one game that's set to stuck. So let's talk visuals. This new system now has a new progress badge. You can find it under badges, game attributes, and you just have to have this new progress badge enabled. Now you may notice that the progress badge system is more than just one shiny new badge, but it's a whole set of icons that are depicting the different states that a game can be in. You can see here that I've got this one here set to not started, unplayed. That's what that looks like. This one is set to active in progress. And you can see here, this crown is done mastered. But how does LaunchBox figure out which badge to show for which value. Let me explain that. Back in version 13.21, we moved all the badges into the media pack system. This means that all of your badges now live under this location: LaunchBox, Images, Media Packs, Badges. In the media pack that you're using, in this case the default would have been the Nostalgic Pack, you'll see a general purpose progress.png image, but then you'll also see a progress folder. Inside the folder, there's a bunch of progress related badges. Now the system works like this. First, it looks for a badge named after both the category and value. For example, this one here, active_pause.png, is looking for a game that has the category and value of active paused. But let's say that image didn't exist. Then the system would just look for a badge that's named after the category, in this case, active.png. But let's say that image didn't exist. That's when it's going to fall back to this generic progress.png badge. This setup makes it super easy for you guys to customize. If you create your own progress categories and values, like the one that I did, backlog, why do I own this? You could just create an image, place it into these folders, and then the game would have that value. I mean, let's do it right now. Go into the progress folder. I made a nice backlog, why do I own this image? Go back into LaunchBox, and there it is. I set this game to backlog, why do I own this? And it's taken on that new badge. Now let's talk about where the real magic begins. Inside of Options, there's a new section called Game Progress Automation. It's designed to do the heavy lifting for you. You don't have to track every game that you play. I mean, unless you want to. But for most users, this feature just works out of the box. It's self-contained, it's smart, it's quietly working behind the scenes to make sure that your game statuses reflect your reality. So why is this so helpful? Because the second that you start up a game, earn an achievement, or rack up enough playtime, LaunchBox will automatically update the game's progress for you. This means that your entire library will actually evolve while you play. One of the best parts of this that I found, you'll actually find games marked as in progress that you totally forgot that you touched. It's really kind of a great way to rediscover your own backlog. And you can see here that for power users, you can still take over the system manually, tweak things to your liking, but really for the majority of users, the defaults will work just fine. And that's the beauty of a system like this. LaunchBox will even do some of the work for you after you upgrade to LaunchBox 13.22 or above. If you ever used the old completed checkbox, it'll automatically convert those to done, mastered after you update to 13.22. Then after that, these rules are going to take over. Now, what do these rules mean? The first one essentially means a game that you haven't touched. And this is the default value that it's going to mark it as, not started, unplayed. The second one here, games with a playtime greater than the following in minutes. So anything that you played for more than this 30 minutes, it's going to set it to in progress. If you earned a single achievement in either Steam, GOG, or Retro Achievements, it's going to be the same deal. Going to mark the game to in progress. Now, if you beat a game in Retro Achievements using either softcore or hardcore mode, it's going to change the status here to done beaten. This one is if you've earned every single achievements on Retro Achievements, but in softcore mode, it'll change it to done completed. And then the last one is games that you got every single achievement on either Steam, GOG, or Retro Achievements in hardcore mode, it's going to change it to done mastered. Now you can see that you can tweak a lot of this stuff, including the minutes here, all of the values, but honestly, like I said, the defaults cover most of the use cases really well. We're also committed to expanding on these rules, so in the future, definitely stay tuned that this might expand. Also, if you're using the free LaunchBox Cloud Statistics Syncing Service, your game's progress will sync right along with everything else. So all you have to do is enable it here, and you're good to go. Whether you're playing on your main desktop or firing up Big Box in your living room setup, your progress updates will go along with you. Now, let's take this even a step further. You can actually build a playlist that auto-updates based on your game's progress. All you have to do is create a new playlist. Maybe this one I'll call it Now Playing. I go to the Auto-Populate tab, click it on, and I'm going to look for the progress field. And I'm going to say is equal to active in progress. And that's it. I can add it somewhere in my hierarchy here. I guess for now, I'll just put it in the root. And I'm done. If I go down, I'll see it in the root where I placed it. And here are all of my games that have the status active in progress. If you play something for 30 minutes or earn an achievement, that game will automatically be added to this list no matter where the game was from. Couple that with the arrange by last played status and hey, you can see I played Ms. Pac-Man last. Now we also can't forget about Big Box. Using the default theme, you'll see the progress badges right below the game description there. And yes, you can update the game statuses from Big Box. All you gotta do is enter into a game, and you'll find the progress down here in the menu. Give it a change, and you're good to go. And that's game progress tracking. It's clean, it's flexible, it's surprisingly addictive, and it finally gives your library a sense of, yeah, I've actually played stuff. Have any questions? Let us know down below. Thanks everybody for watching. We're glad that you're all with us on this journey. And until next time, happy gaming.